Today, we're going to talk about 7 ways to mitigate EMI-related problems. Grounding the VFD properly achieves 2 goals. The first is to limit the risk of shock, and the second is the risk of EMI issues affecting other equipment. The first and arguably most important step is to make sure the VFD and other components are properly earth grounded. The goal of this is to provide a low impedance path for the high frequency noise to drain. A braided ground strap is a great idea because it provides increased surface area. An EMI filter does 2 things. It protects the VFD from high frequency noise, and it drains parasitic currents to the ground instead of allowing them to conduct back to the power supply. We've talked about grounding the VFD to the panel and the motor to the VFD, but grounding the panel to the building's earth ground is often overlooked and just as important. All connections should be made to a single ground block installed on the cabinet subpanel. This ensures there's a single ground point and there's not any ground loops within the system. For sensitive control signals, shielded cabling should be used to mitigate EMI issues. This is especially important for encoder feedback cables. High and low power conductors should be wired as far apart from each other as possible. If they need to pass each other, it should be done at a right angle, and if they're running parallel to each other, it should be at least 8 inches apart. Lastly, and perhaps most simply, is to install a ferrite ring on the output of the VFD. The high inductance of the ferrite ring helps to mitigate EMI issues. Individually, these tips won't fix every EMI-related issue, but used together, they can help prevent EMI issues from affecting your machine. For more information, reach out to us at kebamerica.com.